Rwch groeso cynnes i'r llwyfan eich gwesteir ar gyfer y noson, Jason Mohammed. Please welcome onto the stage your host for this evening, Jason Mohammed.
Indeed, diolch yn fawr iawn, croeso cynnes I chi gyd. Very good evening to you, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this wonderful evening. Please show your appreciation once again for our students here at Cardiff and Vale College Musical Theatre for absolutely smashing Sunday. Please join me in thanking them. Thank you very much. Thank you, team. Sensational. Felly, Noswatha, croeso cynnes I chi gyd. A very good evening, everyone, and welcome to the awards evening, kindly sponsored by University of South Wales. I'd like to extend a very warm welcome to the businesses, partners, colleagues and friends, and most importantly, the award winners and their families this evening. Before we get underway, a little bit of housekeeping. There are no planned fire alarm tests this evening, so if the fire alarm does sound, please make your way to the assembly point at the back of the car park, through the doors to your left. So, awards very, very shortly, but to begin this evening's proceedings, would you please give a very warm welcome to Sharon James, Principal of Cardiff and Vale College, to say a few words.
Croeso, welcome, welcome pow, back to the best nights of the year at Cardiff and Vale calendar. It's great for the first time in 3 years to be back live in this beautiful building here. So thank you all for coming tonight. So tonight is all about celebrating the success of our brilliant students and partners on campus for the first time since 2019. And I'm really delighted as well. Today I've been to London, not to see the Queen, but to see Princess Anne, and she awarded the college this brilliant Princess Royal Training Award. So I did get to shake hands and have a little chat. And this is for all the incredible staff in the organisation, all the teaching staff, all the managers who really work hard every day to give you students the best education you could possibly have. So a big round of applause to the amazing staff. So it's fantastic to see so many students, families, friends and partners of the college and colleagues here tonight. We shall be reflecting upon what has been yet another fantastic year for the college, and especially tonight celebrating the wonderful achievement of our learners from Cardiff and Vale, which is even greater achievement this year because of the obstacles you've had to come, for the challenges from the pandemic. You had to get through far more than any other cohort of learners have ever had to achieve. To do that and to be successful, you really need to be commended. So really well done to all the students who are here tonight to receive the awards. I hope you've enjoyed the evening so far. I hope you enjoyed the hospitality served by your hospitality learners upstairs, and also a fantastic performance by our musical theatre learners. That was a real treat to see this evening. And at this time of year, we've all been waiting for it. All the staff know about it. We have our annual review film. Most of the staff featuring it, they can't wait. They come all prepared every year to star in our feature film. So please have a look back at our key achievements from the college of our staff and students over the last year. Okay, over to you.
We are one of the largest colleges in the UK,
delivering high quality education and training across the capital region of Wales.
Rydym yn 30,000 o ddysgwyr.
Yn dîm o staff brwydfrydig a dynameg sy'n arbenigwyr pwnc a diwydiant.
Training people in top class facilities, online, in the community and in the workplace.
Ledled yr Anferth, a Deyrnas Unedig a Ddu Hwnt.
We are Cardiff and Vale College.
In our most recent inspection, Estyn, His Majesty's Inspectorate for Education and Training, rated as excellent or good across all inspection areas.
Gyda dysgwyr llawn amser fel fi sy'n astudio safon uwch.
All like me studying a career-focused course.
Part-time adult learners like me.
Dysgwyr addysg uwch fel fi.
And apprentices like me.
All going on to achieve our qualifications at CAVC.
Ac mae dysgwyr fel fi yn hapus yma.
With our student satisfaction rate at its highest level yet.
Mae ein dysgwyr yn cyflawni cymwysterau a llawer mwy.
We develop skilled and employable people.
And cynnig cyfleoedd unigryw I bob un ohonom.
To stand out from the crowd and progress.
Including meaningful work placements.
Exciting live briefs.
And industry skills competitions.
Lle cawswm ein cydnabod ymysg y gorau yn Cymru y Deyrnas Unedig a'r byd am y hyn rydym yn ei wneud.
With the college remaining a WorldSkills UK Centre of Excellence.
We challenge more able and talented learners to be the best they can be.
Sy'n cefnogi dysgwyr fel fi I ennill llefydd mewn prifysgolion blaen llaw.
A gwnaethon gyfnogi mwy o dysgwyr I astudio a byw eu bywyd drwy gyffrwng y Gymraeg.
We offer a student experience like no other.
Yn cael eu cyfleoedd yn ei ddilyn ein dyddodebrau ac gwirfeddu ein breuddwydion yn ochr yn ochr ein hastudiaethau.
From performing arts.
To e-sports.
Cadet.
To our sports academies.
Which saw more learners than ever before play for the college and their country.
Competing at the highest level and being crowned national champions.
We continue to place the health and well-being of all of our CABC family at the heart of what we do.
Investing in more initiatives to support staff and learner well-being.
We retained our title as a Microsoft Showcase College.
And our one ffordd of cynnig sgiliau digidol sy'n ei paratoi ar gyfer y dyfodol.
We were recognised as one of the best in the sector and commended for our work.
We were crowned the best college of the UK at the Beacon Awards.
For our work to promote fairness, respect, equality and diversity and inclusion and engagement across the communities we serve.
And we were placed 7th in the National Centre for Diversity's UK Top 100 Index.
We were awarded the Princess Royal Training Award for our commitment to learning and development.
A chafodd ein staff a myfyrwyr yn hygol eu cydnabod ar lefel genedlaethol am eu cyflawniad hefyd.
We see the bigger picture.
Yn cefnogi un o'r dinasoedd sy'n tyfu gyflymaf yn y Deyrnas Unedig.
Contributing £500 million to the economy of the Cardiff Capital Region and more than £1 billion to UK society.
Cardiff and Vale College Group remained the largest provider of apprenticeships in the country.
We invested in our sites and facilities, providing great places to learn now and for future generations.
Gyda chynlluniau fusoddi miliynau o bunnoedd mewn campusau newydd ym Mro Morgannwg.
And we worked globally in new and different ways, growing the number of international students learning with CAVC.
We do the right thing.
Listening, learning and evolving.
And responding to the needs of our community, tackling poverty and inequality, and developing opportunities where they don't currently exist.
We remain the largest provider of English for speakers of other languages.
And our Reach Plus Centre continues to provide a central hub for all that need us.
Our junior apprenticeship programme continued to change the lives of 14 to 16 year olds.
Our Families Learning Together programme continued to support hundreds of families across the region to learn and develop their skills.
And our inclusive approach provides learners a pathway to progress, whatever their starting point.
We are a trusted partner to industry, supporting large employers, SMEs and micro businesses in the private, public and third sector.
Helping organisations to upskill, reskill and diversify their workforce.
Meeting the needs of priority sectors across the capital region.
Ac yn cydweithio I greu cyfleoedd sy'n ysbrydoli gan headlaith nesaf.
And our retail outlets generated income to support learning and for those that need it most in college and in the community.
We are inspirational.
Ambitious, proactive and lead by example.
We are inclusive.
One unique team working together for the benefit of all.
We are influential.
Rydyn ni'n hybu adfywiad economaidd a chymdeithasol.
We're 10 years in and our purpose remains the same. We change lives through learning.
We are Cardiff and Vale College.
Niw Coleg Cardiff ar Fro.
Nasamos Cardiff and Vale College.
Ahna Cardiff and Vale College.
Nahna Cardiff and Vale College.
Niw Coleg Cardiff ar Fro.
That is fantastic. It's lovely to see so many of you in the audience on that film tonight as well. So well done. And Jason, that you might be wanting to recruit a few more for BBC Wales or the Academy. Oh, thank you. But seriously, we are really proud of the achievements as a college and we are committed to making a difference. At Cardiff and Vale College, our goal is to develop skilled and employable people. It's all too easy for a college to simply ensure its students get their qualifications and nothing more. At Cardiff and Vale College, we believe there's more to it than that. We want to provide the best experiences, best opportunities, industry links and progression routes. We want to ensure that all our students don't just reach their potential, but stand out from the crowd and progress. We're also ambitious and we're always looking for new opportunities, new ways of working and new partnerships that can help us to do this and make a lasting impact on lives in our region. The fantastic stories you hear today will showcase a lot of this. And honestly, it's the best part of the year when we sit down and we read the stories and achievements of our learners, and we can see how much they've overcome to achieve this success, and it's really what it's all about. So tonight, really enjoy listening to the success of these young people. These students show huge commitment, drive, and determination, and they've done so well to reach their goals, and we wish them all the best in their future careers. So a huge congratulations to all our winners tonight. I want to say well done for persevering during some of the most difficult times we've had in education. Well done for achieving that qualification. Well done for achieving that qualification in many personal adversities that many of you have been going through. Well done for achieving that qualification and winning that sports achievement or winning that medal in the World Skills. You've done all that and more. And most of all, I want to thank you all for being such an inspiration to us as educators, because it's you that make us want to do better every single year. So well done. Enjoy this evening. Cry, whoop, scream, cheer on your family and friends as they've well-deserved awards that they achieved tonight. So thank you all very much. Thank you. Diolch yn fawr iawn.
Well, Sharon, thank you very much indeed. Diolch yn fawr iawn. And I have to say, I spotted a few superstars there on screen. As someone who works in broadcasting, I think we've got a new generation of broadcasters and maybe members of the academy, which we set up here at Cardiff and Vale College. And once again, please show your appreciation. Put your hands together for Sharon James, please. Thank you very much. Thank you, Sharon. So by now, hopefully you've got your awards brochure in front of you, and you will have seen the award categories will be presented tonight in order as they appear in your brochure. So please flick through and have a look. If you are presenting or receiving an award this evening, then I'll be calling you onto the stage. Please listen carefully to your names. Don't miss your cue. And when your name is called, please make your way to the stage and walk up the stairs in the center. When you get to the stage, you'll be presented with a trophy, pose for a quick photo, and then if you could walk straight back to the back of the venue and meet our social media team, we'd be very grateful for a picture and put you on social media. First set of awards, ladies and gentlemen, are the Curriculum Area Awards, which are awarded to learners who've demonstrated excellence, achievement, and progression within a curriculum area. These awards are open to all full-time and part-time learners that studied during the 2021-2022 academic year. So our first award of the evening is the Aerospace Award, and to present it, would you please welcome Martin Smith, Head of Aerospace Engineering, to the stage. Martin, a very good evening to you. Noswathar, there's the trophy for you to present. Thank you. And I'm delighted to say that the winner of this award is Jacob Scott. Jacob. Jacob is a pleasure to teach, and it is 3 years at Cardiff and Vale College. He's been top of his class, both theoretically and practically, has shown great work ethic and leadership in tasks. His countless hours of research, study, and revising have contributed to his excellent grades. He achieved a distinction in his enhanced program and has since progressed onto the HND in aeronautical engineering, also secured employment with E-Cube, an aerospace company based at RAF St. Athan, which is a real testament to the quality of his work. Congratulations to you. Many, many congratulations. Jacob, thank you. Well done. Good luck to you, Jacob. And if you can head to the back of the arena for your social media picture, thank you very much indeed. Well done. Our next award is the A-Level Award. To present this, please welcome to the stage Kerry Moore, Deputy Head of A-Levels. Welcome, Kerry. Yeah, there's the trophy. And the winner of this award, and please feel free to cheer. You can whoop, you can do whatever you want. Please welcome our winner, Anis Wiltshire. Congratulations to Anis, a student of exceptional ability, and during their time at Cardiff and Vale College achieved exceptional results. A star in classics and history, an A in chemistry, and a distinction won in the Scholars Programme qualification. The extended essay that Anis prepared for Scholars was the best submission their nominator has read from A Level 3 student. In addition, this level achievement richly rewarded by Anis's acceptance in September of a place at Wadham College, Oxford, to read classics. Amazing. Many, many congratulations. Wow. Incredible. And as Sharon said earlier, it's these stories, these incredible testaments, which show just what a remarkable job not only the learners are doing here at Cardiff and Vale College, but also the incredible staff. Congratulations to Anis. Okay, the next award is Art, Design and Multimedia Award. And to present this one, please welcome Kristen Harries, Head of Department for the Creative Industries. This is what I love. Even the staff are getting a big round of applause. This is absolutely wonderful. Kristen, thank you very much indeed. Okay, and the winner is Jared Sullivan. So let me tell you a bit about Jared. Joined the Creative Media course in 2019 and applied himself fantastically, graduating 3 years later with a distinction and an A in his English and Maths GCSEs. He won numerous awards for his films while studying at the college, such as Best Narrative Documentary Film at the USW Film Festival. His educational journey wasn't easy, but he's demonstrated that it's possible to progress through education with hard work and resilience. And Jared now plans to apply for a place at university next year to continue his learning. Please give Jared a very, very warm round of applause. Well done, Jared. Brilliant. I love that. Hard work and resilience. Without that, you've not got much. Many congratulations. Thank you, Kristen, for presenting that award. Lots of awards to get through, ladies and gentlemen, which is why we are rattling through them. The next award is the Automotive Award. To present this, I'd like to invite on the stage Kerry Hill, Deputy Head of Engineering and Automotive. Welcome, Kerry. Good evening. Noswatha. And the winner of this award is Keaton Lee Morgan. Very dramatic bit of music, may I say. Fantastic. Right, okay, now then, despite facing some difficult times outside college, Keaton Lee very rarely missed a day. And when he did attend, he turned up with a positive attitude and was always willing to apply himself. Passed his level 2 heavy vehicle course on time and with good exam scores. His employer has always supplied great feedback, saying how valuable an employee he's become. He's now progressed to level 3 and is keeping up the quality of his work. Many congratulations, Keaton Lee. Fantastic. Keep up the great work. And thank you, Kerry, for presenting the award. The next award is a very important one. It is the Bakery Award. And to present, always get to cheer that one, the Bakery Award. It must be our love of the bake-off. And to present the two awards, I'd like to welcome onto the stage Rachel Bartlett, Head of Department for Retail and Commercial Enterprise. Good evening, Rachel. Nice to see you. And I can tell you that the winner is Tahira Khalid. So, Tahira started on an ESOL course at the college 3 years ago and progressed through levels 1, 2, and 3 of her catering qualifications before making her move into bakery. She successfully passed her level 2 diploma, and soon enough she was excelling on her level 3 course, producing many excellent products, and attended the Alliance for Bakery Students and Trainees competition at Alton Towers. She's now working with schools, sharing her talent and passing on her knowledge and skills to others. Please give Tahira a very warm welcome. Many congratulations. Rachel's staying on stage with me to present this next prize. The next award is the Beauty and Complementary Therapy Award. And the winner is Nikita Wheeler. Nikita not here?
I'm not sure.
Nikita? No Nikita. Oh, that's okay. Okay. All right, okay. Let me just say a few words about Nikita, shall we? Nikita was quick to demonstrate her talents on her level 3 course in theatrical, special effects, hair and media makeup, and keen to test her ability further, she attended Work Skills UK in the creative media competition, successfully made it to the final round, also put herself forward to work on a BBC commissioned short film with It's My Shout, They Are Marvellous, earning herself industry credits. She works in a salon outside college and has now progressed onto higher education here at Cardiff and Vale College. We shall make sure Nikita gets her award. Thank you, Rachel.
Thank you, Nikita.
Well done, Nikita. Thank you, Rach. The next award is the Building Services Award, and to present this one, I'd like to welcome to the stage Gareth Elloway, Head of Building Services. Good evening, Gareth. Lovely to see you. Noswatha. And the winner of this prize is Aram Elbadian. Congratulations to you, Aram. Aram has excelled in all aspects of his learning and is always pushing himself to do better. He entered a UK Skill Build regional event this year, winning first place, and just last month he represented the college and Wales in the World Skills UK National Finals in Edinburgh. He is committed and driven, has now progressed to a foundation qualification in construction and the built environment, and is sure to make a fantastic contribution to his trade. Please give Aram another huge round of applause. Thank you. Well done, Aram. Fantastic. Such amazing stories. Aram, don't forget your social media picture as well. These are brilliant stories, aren't they? And making us all feel so proud at the college this evening. Okay, on we go to the next award. And it is the Business Award. And to present this one, would you please welcome to the stage Fiona Tierney, Head of Business and IT. Welcome, Fiona. Croeso cynnes. And the winner is Hanifa Salam. Well, congratulations to Hanifa, a model student during her 2 years at the college. She applied herself in every lesson and was a great support to everyone in her class, always turning up with a smile and always willing to help others. And she also attended a 4-week internship and 2-week work experience, during which time the employers were very, very impressed with Hanifa's excellent knowledge, and has since secured a training job with Sky, which is a great reward for the hard work she's put in. Let's give her a big round of applause and good luck with your future career, Hanifa. Thank you very much. Congratulations to Fiona and Hanifa. I'm not sure if I can contractually say Sky, but too late, I've said it. Anyway, we'll see how that goes tomorrow. The next award is the Childcare and Early Years Award. Unfortunately, the winner of this award is unable to join us this evening. However, we'd still like to recognise their achievements, and hopefully she'll be watching via the live stream. So I'll announce the winner and say a few words, and you can give a big cheer as well. Let's do it. And the winner is Maisha Haq. We even got some sparklers for you as well, Maisha. Definition of a success story is Maisha. Since arriving at the college, she's completed 280 hours of work placement in the Level 2 Health and Social Care course and went on to complete another 720 hours of work placement at Level 3 to achieve her full qualification and Welsh back. Having completed 4 years worth of college courses, her mind has always been on the future and has since moved on to the workplace. Let's give her another big round of applause. Well done. Building on to the next award, see, is the Construction Award. And to present this, please welcome to the stage Barry Alford, Deputy Head of Construction. Good evening, Barry. Croeso. And I'm delighted to say that the winner of this award is Dylan Dumbleton. Good evening, Dylan, and many congratulations. Dylan excels in both the practical and theory elements of his chosen trade route. He was successful in the regional heats of Skill Build competition earlier this year, and presented the college once again in the World Skills UK National Finals in Edinburgh. Dylan's skills have improved dramatically over the past 12 months, has been described as a pleasure to teach, and always gives 110% in every activity he undertakes. Well done, Dylan. Brilliant, fantastic. Congratulations. Llong gyfarchiad y mawr. Ardderchog. Thank you, Barry. Diolch o galon, and well done to you, Dylan. Our next award is the Education and Training Award. To present this, please welcome to the stage Yusuf Ibrahim, Assistant Principal for Academic Studies and Sixth Form. Good evening, Yusuf. Good to see you. And the winner is Sudhav Khan. Now then, this is a great story. When Sudhav began her PGCE course, she brought an enthusiasm and a strong commitment that enabled her to complete her studies with distinction. She was able to solve problems quickly and effectively whilst listening to others, and that transferred into her teaching practice. She is a very friendly individual, bright, motivated, and always willing to learn and develop. That willingness earned her the role of sabbatical officer, and she's since taken up a post as a lecturer in humanities here at Cardiff and Vale College. What a remarkable story. Sudhav, many congratulations. Congratulations. Absolutely wonderful story. And Yusuf, thank you very much for presenting that award. Okay, the next award is the Engineering Award. Now, once again, sadly, the winner of this award can't join us this evening. As previously, let's announce the winner and say a few words about them and give them a big cheer in case Mitchell is watching on the live stream. We hope he is. And the winner is Mitchell Perrott. Well done to Mitchell. A Dow Corning apprentice has shown excellent commitment to his course, his attendance record and punctuality, and his attitude to learning all simply outstanding. Always sets a great example to his peer group. One of his standout accomplishments was a 96% average exam score across the 8 modules of the course. Has been described as a pleasure to work and teach during his time at the college and also as an apprentice. So hopefully Mitchell's tuning in at home to our wonderful live stream carried out by our brilliant technical team this evening. So Mitchell, if you're watching, many, many congratulations. Mitchell Perrott, ladies and gentlemen. The magic of technology, eh? The next award is the English for Speakers of Other Languages Award. And to present this award, please welcome to the stage Judith Scanlon, Head of ESOL. So Judith is now going to collect 2 awards because we have 2 winners for this award. And please put your hands together for Croeso I, Mina Matab and Shirin Talebi. Good evening to you both. congratulations. Now, Mina and Shirin have been model students who've gone above and beyond the curriculum and made a lasting contribution to the department. They led an innovative metaverse project in creating a bespoke area on CAVC's virtual campus and were selected to represent the college in receiving guests from Digital Data and Technology Agency, JISC, to whom they professionally presented their project. Mina and Shirin both passed across all skills and subject areas and progressed onto level 2. Absolutely fantastic. And Hugol, fantastic. Many, many congratulations, Mina and Shirin. Thank you very much. These are just remarkable stories, aren't they? Which again show the commitment not only of the learners, but also the fantastic staff here. The next award of the evening is the Hairdressing Award. To present this award, please welcome to the stage Maria McCarthy, Deputy Head of Hair, Beauty and Complementary Therapies. Big cheer there, Maria. Big cheer. Big fans in the audience tonight. And the winner is Samuel Howells. Diane Samuel, here we go then. Samuel went above and beyond on his course, not only in his own learning, but also as a class rep. Set a true example to all the students in his class, strived to do the best in theory and practical. Samuel always asked for extra videos or reading so he didn't lose his skills over half terms, even organized a well-being day and made sure all learners joined in. Samuel has since been working on his own barbering business and building his client base. Anything you can recommend? No? A turkey, thank you very much indeed. Thank you very much, thank you. You're gonna go a long way, Samuel. You're gonna go a long way. Give a big round of applause. Well done, Samuel. Samuel, turkey. That's the line of the night. Thank you. The next award is the Health and Care Award. To present this award, please welcome to the stage Victoria Jenkins, Head of Health and Care. Hello, Victoria. Good evening. Nos vemos. And I'm delighted to announce that the winner of this award is Sarah Hart. Congratulations, Sarah. During her first year on the foundation degree in youth and social care, Sarah worked with families and individuals who've experienced domestic abuse as part of her placement module. Sarah has shown a natural ability and flair working in this area and has secured a permanent job with Aval Avro, working with the women and families in the Vale of Glamorgan and at the Women's Refuge. The agency are fully supportive of Sarah's desire to progress educationally, and she's currently studying her counselling level 2 in order to further her communication skills with vulnerable people. Incredible achievement. Please give Sarah a very warm welcome. Sarah, thank you very much. We are very proud of your achievements. Thank you. The next award is the Hospitality and Catering Award. To present this one, please welcome to the stage Eric Couturier, Deputy Head of Catering and Hospitality. Hello, Eric. Very good to see you. Good evening to you. Nos vemos. And the winner is Mackenzie Skuse. Right, here we go. Mackenzie, very focused and driven individual, obtaining as much work experience as he could to develop his progress onto the level 3 hospitality course. Mackenzie's now found employment and has a burning ambition to keep progressing in his trade, showing a great deal of maturity and commitment. His journey from when he started at the college to where he is now has been absolutely phenomenal, demonstrating if you set your heart on achieving your goals, determination, desire, and hard work certainly pays off. Absolutely brilliant. Well done, Mackenzie, and we wish you the very best with the future. Thank you very much indeed. Mackenzie, ladies and gentlemen. loving the message that's coming through tonight about desire and hard work and determination. Absolutely fantastic. And Hugol. Right, the next award is the IT Award. To present this award, please welcome to the stage Fiona Tierney, Head of Business and IT. Welcome back, Fiona. And the winner of this award, please give a very warm welcome to Grace Lewis. Now, yet again, Grace has been described as a joy to teach. How wonderful to read these incredible messages out about our learners. She's extremely focused, asks lots of questions, completes all her work to an excellent standard. Importantly, she also lifts others around her, creating a real community within the group. She achieved an overall distinction grade and has now progressed to the second year of her Level 3 computing course, where she continues to work exceptionally hard and supports her peers to do the same. Absolutely amazing. Please give it up for Grace. Congratulations to you, Grace. Okay, moving on to our next award. It's the Performing Arts Award. To present this, please welcome to the stage Kat Keeble Buckle, Deputy Head of Creative Industries. You'll have to keep the clapping going because she's got about 10 more steps. Hello, Kat. Good evening to you. Not with that. And I'm delighted to say that the winner in this award category is Mehmet Ongun. Right, now, Mehmet is very busy with assessment at the moment, so unfortunately isn't able to join us this evening, but we're honoured to have his dad here to collect the award on his behalf. So dad is here. And as a dad myself, I'm going to enjoy this moment because this must be lovely. What I'm about to read out about your boy is lovely. So Mehmet made a great contribution to the department during the course of his Level 3 Extended Diploma in Performing Arts. A very strong performer who is confident in his own abilities, always willing to give things a go in and around the creative department, such as when he co-compared the end of year creative showcase earlier this year, drawing plaudits for his delivery on the night. Mehmet has since gone on to study at Emile Dale's Performance Academy. And for your boy, that must be lovely as dad hearing that. So many congratulations and pass on our very good wishes. Thank you for joining us. Thank you very much indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, Kat, and let's call him Mehmet's dad. Mehmet's dad. Dad Mehmet. Dayan, Ardachog. Right then, the next award is the Preparation for Work, Life and Learning Award. And to present this award, please welcome to the stage James Donaldson, Assistant Principal for Learner Journey. Very smart. Look at this. Wow. I feel like we should have an award for the best dressed gentleman this evening, of which you come second. James, a very good evening to you. And the winner is Ocean Cotty. So whilst Ocean gets the award, over the last year, Ocean has developed into an amazing young lady. Her work in class is excellent, has become a great support to her fellow students too. She's been picked for the college football team and was chosen as player of the tournament at the Pan Ability Welsh Football Tournament, which CAVC won. She also participated in the Duke of Edinburgh's award and has secured a place on level one public services here at the college. She's now talking about becoming a paramedic, which is a real testament to her progress and ambition. Amazing. Ocean, congratulations and keep it going. Fantastic. Well done, you. Thank you, James. Round of applause for James as well, looking dapper tonight. Come on, James. Okay. Moving swiftly on, the next award is the Public Services Award. And to present this, please welcome to the stage Darren Robinson, Deputy Head of Tourism, Sport and Public Services. Good evening to you, Darren. And I'm delighted to say that the winner of this award is Chamali Vikramachige. Good evening to Chamali and well done. Despite initially lacking a lot of self-confidence, Chamali went on to prove what she was capable of. Her work was always excellent, so much so she achieved distinction. And being at college also gave her the confidence to go on and learn to drive, which was something she shied away from in the past, but managed to pass first time as well. So yes, why not? Come on, give her a round of applause for that as well. And I love this final sentence, just before you go, I love this final sentence. She's a shining example of what conquering your fears looks like, and if her humility and respect could be bottled and sold, it would make an absolute fortune. There you go. Beautiful. Well done, Chamali. That is just so lovely. So lovely that we can make a fortune with your energy and also humility. How lovely is that? Thank you, Darren, for presenting that award. The next award is one very close to my heart. It is, of course, the Sport Award. To present this, please welcome to the stage James Young, Head of Tourism, Sport and Public Services. Big cheer. Big cheer. Welcome, James. Very lovely to see you. And the winner is Josh Brown. Now, Josh was a very diligent student. He did well in adapting the theoretical side of the course to improve his sporting abilities and achieved a distinction in his BTEC extended diploma in sport and has since progressed to university. Well done, Josh. Also an outstanding member of the Basketball Academy, leading the team to championship titles in both the AOC Welsh Regional Championship and also the Wales League. And that led to his selection to represent the Welsh under-19s national team in the Four Nations tournament in Cardiff. I guess you could call it a slam dunk. Many, many congratulations. Fantastic achievement. Well done, Josh. Brilliant stuff. Very proud of you, Josh. Fantastic. James, you're staying with me because the next award is the Travel and Tourism Award. And the winner in this category is Megan Curtis. Now then, Megan first completed the Level 2 City and Guilds Diploma in Travel and Tourism and then progressed onto the Level 3 Diploma, where she was successful in gaining a place on the Erasmus programme. That took Megan to Mallorca, where she completed work experience in a hotel. Her growth in confidence and ability has been evident since returning. She's currently working very hard to achieve on the second year of the Level 3 Diploma. And in the future, Megan aims to study events management at university. Many congratulations to Megan. Fantastic. Well done, Megan. These are just remarkable, heartwarming stories, and we wish you all the very best in your career. Thank you, James, for presenting that award. That concludes the Curriculum Area Awards. We now move on to the Cross College Awards. Now, these celebrate learners from across Cardiff and Vale College who've been chosen for their outstanding achievements, overcoming any obstacles and proactively contributing to creating a positive community for everyone at the college. The first award, therefore, is the Adult and Community Award. Cardiff and Vale College work with community partners across Cardiff and the Vale and are one of the largest providers of post-19 education and adult learning in the country, as we saw in the film earlier. Every year, many learners in our community take their first step back into learning through courses led by Cardiff and Vale College. So to present this award, please welcome to the stage Chris Pemberton, Vice Principal for Curriculum and Standards. Good evening, Chris. Noswatha. And the winner here is Fei Saho. Congratulations to Faye. Faye works with her son Suleiman when attending family learning sessions and also brings along her little girl. The development of Faye's skills and understanding of how to help and support Suleiman has been outstanding. She constantly strives to learn more. It's a pleasure to watch her work with her children. Faye has grown in confidence so much since she joined the course and is now even confident enough to offer advice to other parents too, which is a testament to her personal growth. Please give a very warm round of applause to Faye. Congratulations, Faye. Llong Rocheda, and we wish you all the very best. The next award is the Apprenticeship Award. Cardiff and Vale College Group are the largest provider of apprenticeships and training programmes in the country, working with partners to support thousands of apprentices in their chosen career path. To present this award, please welcome to the stage Alan Mackey, Head of Work-Based Learning. Good evening, Alan. Noswathati. And the winner here is Omar Wahid. Good evening to Omar and many congratulations. A real ambassador for what can be achieved through career-focused learning at the college and in an apprenticeship. After starting on a level two program, Omar quickly secured an apprenticeship, completed 3 years of study. During the time with Cardiff and Vale College, has won 2 skills competitions and 1 WorldSkills UK award, seeing him recognized as among the best new talent in the sector across the country. Omar now works for Davis Motor Company in Cardiff, which deals with prestigious vehicles such as Bentleys and Aston Martins. So if you want an Aston Martin tonight, he's the man to talk to. A testament to the high level of his skills in the trade. What a remarkable story once again. Omar, we're very proud of you. We wish you all the very best. Many congratulations. Thank you, Omar. And because he's won an award tonight, he's very kindly offered 75% off all Aston Martins between now and the close of business tomorrow. So, what, 85? That's a bit too much, Omar, come on. Right, our next award is the Junior Apprenticeship Award, launched in September 2016. The Pioneering Junior Apprentice Programme is a partnership between the College, Cardiff Council and local schools to offer vocational career paths to 14 to 16 year olds, which received UK-wide recognition. Now, the winner can't be here tonight, but I can tell you that the winner is Molly Danes. So as before, just in case Molly is watching at home on the live stream or watching back, let's give her a big round of applause and also tell you a bit about her. Molly joined the Junior Apprentice Programme in 2021, had a few ups and downs during her first year, but over the last year, made a miraculous turnaround with real determination and so much hard work. She knuckled down, completed her hair and beauty coursework. She grew in confidence, enrolling on a post-16 course and taking on some paid work at the college so she could support herself. Molly has become an impressive young woman with a desire to go to university and study law. So in case she is watching, let's give her another huge round of applause. Well done, Molly. So such uplifting stories tonight, and that's why Sharon was absolutely right at the start of the evening when she quite rightly pointed out that this is one of the most prestigious nights here at the college, and indeed across Welsh education. The next award is the Higher Education Award. CAVC works with a network of university partners to offer a broad range of higher education at the college, and became the first college in Wales to gain QAA approval to offer and award their own higher education provision, supporting more people to achieve university qualifications and develop higher skills each year. So to present this award, please welcome to the stage Leon Annett, Dean of Higher Education. Good evening to you, Leon Noswathar. And the winner is Annabelle Legger. Well done to Annabelle, a strong student who was a main leader of her cohort during her aircraft engineering degree, driving her group to achieve. Her final year dissertation was highly innovative, focused on investigating the potential of using an ultraviolet light beam as a means of sterilizing aircraft washroom facilities. Annabelle went on to achieve a first class honors and has since progressed to Cranfield University to study for a master's in air transport economics. What an incredible story. Annabelle, congratulations. These are just amazing stories, aren't they? I mean, they're just so, so uplifting. The next award is the International Award. Cardiff Vale College have a renowned international profile that has grown year on year, as many of you know, attracting more and more international students and building new and exciting partnerships right across the globe. Now, unfortunately, the winner of this award can't join us this evening as they're busy with their studies at the University of Edinburgh, but hopefully watching at home. And the winner is Rosalie. Now, Rosalie, as she likes to be known, is studying at AS in Cardiff and Vale College's Shanghai Centre in China before completing her A2 in Cardiff, was recognised as an exceptional student on both sites, achieved 3 A stars and 1 A grade at A levels, which made her one of the top 3 students in the college. Now studying English literature at Edinburgh University, one of the longest established departments in the world. Let's give it up once again for Rosalie. Wonderful, well done, Rosalie. Right, the next two awards relate to the Welsh language, yr iaith Gymraeg, and are sponsored by colleague Cymraeg Cenedlaethol. The awards recognise learners' achievements in learning through the language and also promoting it to other learners on campus. So to present these awards, please welcome to the stage Chair of Corporation Geraint Evans and Dr. David Tristan, Registrar and Senior Academic Manager for colleague Cymraeg Cenedlaethol. Noswathar Geraint, Noswathar David. Lovely Welty. And the winner of the Bilingual Learner Award is Enillydd y Gwobr Dysgwr Dwyieithog yw Grace MacDonald. Congratulations to Grace. Llong gyfarched y mawr I Grace. Full of enthusiasm for the Welsh language, takes up every available opportunity to further develop her Welsh skills. Also encourages other Welsh language learners and promotes college events by sharing details and creating resources for specific Welsh celebrations. She also showed initiative by bringing new learners to the lessons, always had a bright and enthusiastic attitude towards the Welsh language and also her own learning at the college. And mae hwn yn bwysig iawn. Fel dysgwr, dwi'n gwybod, as a learner, I know pa mor bwysig ydi o, how important it is to speak Welsh at any opportunity, I siarad Cymraeg a bob gyfle. Da iawn, arferchog, da iawn ti. Arferchog Grace, llong gyfarchiad y mawr. The next award is the Outstanding Commitment to the Welsh and Gwobr Ymrwyad Arbennig i'r Gymraeg, and the winner is, ar enillydd yw, Fion Llywelyn. Da iawn, Fion. Congratulations to Fion. Now, Fion is an outstanding student who excelled in her chosen subjects during her time at Cardiff and Vale College. She first joined the college's Welsh Ambassador Scheme in 2021, has been full of enthusiasm and ideas to raise the profile of the Welsh language across our campuses. She also took part in Welsh Language Wellbeing podcasts and also broadcasts as part of the Media Academy that we set up here just last year. And since being on that academy and being at Cardiff and Vale College, she has since earned herself a BBC Wales Welsh Language Production Apprenticeship and has just started working for BBC Cymru Wales. Many congratulations, Fion. We're very, very proud of you. Da iawn, Fion. Geraint, Dafydd, diolch yn fawr iawn. I just want to say, seeing as Fion was part of the first cohort of the Media Academy that I set up here at Cardiff and Vale College, and my heartfelt thanks go to Kay, to Sharon, to Yusuf, to Mike, and the support team that I've had in setting up this academy. And what pleases me most is that what's remarkable about Fion's story, for those of you who don't know this, Fion was minding her own business on day two of the academy in the library in November 2021. And she said, "What have you been doing upstairs?" And she won't mind me telling you the story. And we said, Yusuf and I said, "Oh, we've been doing a media academy. We've been setting a podcast from scratch," which is week one of the academy that I set up here at Cardiff and Vale College. And so proud to stand here and talk about that academy. That was November 2021. Remember that date in your minds. So this was Fion, who didn't know what we were doing upstairs. So she came on day three, thoroughly enjoyed it. Then she came to week two, in our radio broadcast week at the Tramshed, and absolutely smashed it out of the park. Was incredible. And suddenly grew this appetite, and developed this appetite for learning about the creative industries and media. And then she came to our TV week, one of our presenters, when we hosted the Cardiff and Vale College One Show, where we overtook Kay's office and turned it into a TV studio. Sorry about that, Kay. I hope we didn't leave a mess. And Fiona absolutely smashed that. And about then, she started applying for apprenticeships. And then got onto a BBC Wales apprenticeship scheme at the end of May 2022. And she was minding her own business back in November 2021. It's a remarkable story. And in 25 years of working in the media and broadcasting, it is one of the proudest moments of my career to see Fion walk into BBC Wales with a lanyard around her neck, going into that brand new building at Central Square. And in November 2021, was working here at Cardiff and Vale College. It is truly a remarkable story. And also, we've heard this throughout the evening about drive and determination. Well, Fion and many other learners have shown that in abundance. So Fion, I'm very, very proud of you. We all are at the college. We're proud of all our learners. But I just wanted to tell you that story about just what an opportunity can do and how it can change your career path. So never, ever be afraid of trying something new. I think that's the story. Well, when it comes to Fion. So Fion, many congratulations. Llong fawr iawn. And please remember me when you present in the One Show. The next award is the Performance Sport Award. Cardiff and Vale College offers an inspirational sporting environment which enables students to focus on their chosen sport, whether in one of the academies or pursuing an individual sporting goal whilst gaining a quality academic or vocational education. To present this award, please welcome to the stage Kay Martin, Group Principal. Good evening, Kay. Nos wath da. And the winner of this award is Lucas De La Rua. Well done to Lucas, congratulations. Lucas has a genuine X factor to his game. His pace, balance and agility are real assets on the field of play, and provides a particular threat from set-piece situations. His speed from the base of the scrum and his physicality, both in the collision and with the ball, have earned Lucas plaudits from coaches at all levels. He is definitely a superstar for the future. Lucas, congratulations. Tlong Wel Khamau, Rad Lechon. Amazing. That concludes the Cross College Awards, and we now move on to the Business and Partner Awards. These next awards are given to employers and partners of the college who recognize their outstanding commitment to education and training. This year, Cardiff and Vale College has built more partnerships and businesses than ever before, developing their staff, forging ahead with new projects, creating collaborative educational routes for students, and opening up a world of opportunities at Cardiff and Vale College. Please welcome to the stage to present the first of these Business and Partner Awards, Chair of Corporation Geraint Evans and Vice Principal for Funding and Planning, James Scorey. Good evening, James. Hefyd, Geraint, croeso nôl. Welcome back. The first winner of the Business and Partner Awards is Dow Chemicals. Yeah, we got the whole team with us tonight. Yeah, fantastic. How lovely is that? That's going to make a lovely picture. As a host business to Project Search over the last 4 years, Dow Chemicals has provided over 35 Cardiff and Vale College learners with internships and ensured that the programme has become an integral part of the on-site culture. The interns are supported to develop skills in a variety of roles. Many have progressed into employment with Dow. This partnership has, in the words of graduated interns, changed their lives and is now cemented a place for the future. Well done, and thank you for all your incredible work. Dow Chemicals. Thank you, James. Geraint, you're staying with me again. To present this next award, please can I ask Richard Pugsley, Deputy Chief Operating Officer, to join me on the stage. Nice to see you, Richard. The next Business and Partner Award goes to FinTech Wales. College collaborates closely with FinTech Wales on behalf of their members in engaging the sector to identify skills gaps in Cardiff Capital Region's FinTech sector. The information was used to create two pilot coding academies, intensive 10-week programs covering technical and project management skills. The academies were a resounding success, with over 76 qualifications obtained and at least half having found jobs or progressed into further education so far. It is a remarkable achievement. Please give FinTech Wales a huge round of applause. Well done, and keep up the great work. Thank you, FinTech Wales. Diolch o galon, fantastic. Okay, the next award. Please can we ask Alan Rees, Director of International, to join us on the stage. Good evening to you, Alan Noswathar. And our next winner of the Business and Partner Awards is Football Class Academy. Now, Yusuf Aki's Football Class Academy has been an exceptional partner of Cardiff and Vale College for the last 5 years, using the facilities to coach football and teach English to students from overseas through daily training, championship matches, nutritional advice, physical preparation, and cultural outings. Yusuf is professional, forward-thinking, and a pleasure to work with, and Cardiff and Vale College hope to see this partnership grow further year on year. Football Class Academy, thank you very much, and keep up the great work, Yusuf. I'm not too sure if Football Class Academy gave a big enough cheer. Do you want to do that again? Yeah, they're in the house. They're here. Yeah, they're here. Well done. Absolutely wonderful. Yusuf, keep up the fantastic work. Brilliant. Okay, to present our next business and partner award, please can we ask Wayne Carter, Head of Widening Participation, to join us on the stage. Good evening, Wayne. Noswatha. The next business and partner award goes to Ministry of Life Education. Now, Ministry of Life Education started their work with young people as street-based youth workers on the streets of our capital city, providing opportunities to the hardest to reach. Over the last 7 years, they've developed and grown an alternative full-time education provision in partnership with our college. They've engaged with over 320 young people per year, developed a curriculum that engages, motivates, and progresses individuals into further education, training, or employment. It is such an incredible project and important work. Please give it up for Ministry of Life Education. Absolutely amazing. So proud to be associated with that. And Wayne, thank you very much to presenting that award. Okay, to present our final business and partner award, please join us in welcoming back to the stage Vice Principal for Funding and Planning, James Scorey. And as James makes his way to the stage, I can announce that the final winner of the Business and Partner Awards goes to Transport for Wales. Congratulations. So, a little background. Earlier this year, Cardiff and Vale College worked with Transport for Wales on a very special event to help launch their first class menu, cooked by chefs on the train. Catering and hospitality learners were tasked with creating a starter, main course and dessert that could be provided on their first class service. Learners partnered with the chefs to create their masterpieces, which were then considered by a panel of 8 judges. Cardiff and Vale College working closely with TfW to devise a programme to help support their catering and cleaning teams across Wales, and also cooperating on a number of other courses. It is a remarkable initiative. Congratulations, Transport for Wales. Thank you very much indeed for all your amazing work. Congratulations. Ardechon. Ardechon. Diolch yn iawn. Right then, the next award. Thank you, Geraint. Sterling work. 6 awards, I make that, yeah? And not finished yet. The next award of the evening, sponsored by the University of South Wales, is awarded to 2 students who've contributed to a positive learning and working environment and gone above and beyond to support their peers, not only in their study areas, but also more broadly in the day-to-day life on campus. So to present the CAVC Family Award, please welcome back to the stage Kay Martin, Group Principal, and Adam Williams, Deputy Dean for the Faculty of Businesses and Creative Industries. So, we've got Kay to collect the first award, and Adam, now he's here, I can tell you that the first winner of the CAVC Family Award is Saffron van der Kolk Pello. congratulations to Saffron, an extremely valued member of the student union team, always busy in her roles as a student governor and sabbatical officer. She worked very hard to support students across college campuses, delivering campaigns, information, events, and competitions engaging students in the wider college community. Saffron has since gone on to study geography with international relations at the University of Plymouth. Many congratulations, Saffron. Llong gyfarched y mawr, ar ddechog. And we wish you all the very best, Saffron. Our second winner of the CAVC Family Award goes to Tom Capel. Right, well done to Tom. Very well known in the Cardiff and Vale College family for his achievements with the Rugby Academy, leading the team to winning the Welsh Rugby Union Schools and Colleges Cup in 2021, and on a landmark cultural tour of South Africa. He was selected as captain in recognition of his maturity, and he went over and above in his role within the team. He is described as a kind and considerate young man, always supportive to others around him. Tom is now studying civil engineering at Cardiff University and was recently selected for the Cardiff University Super Rugby squad. Outstanding. Many congratulations to you, Tom. Fantastic. Well done, Tom. The next award of the evening is a very special one. It's the Alumni Award, one I've been particularly looking forward to announcing this evening after being the winner of a few years ago as a very proud Cardiff and Vale College alumni myself. Now, the college aims to recognise and celebrate the professional accomplishments and contributions of former students as role models to inspire the future generations. Alumni Award winners are people who've made inspiring journeys, distinguished themselves in their careers or their communities. So to present this very special award, the Alumni Award, please welcome to the stage Mark Roberts, Chief Operating Officer, and Sharon James, Principal of Cardiff and Vale College. Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Sharon. And the first of our two winners of the Alumni Award is Tegan Frizzell. Now, Tegan was an exemplary student during her time at Cardiff and Vale College, achieving A's in maths, chemistry, and Welsh back. During this time, she also represented Wales as an international swimmer. Upon finishing at Cardiff and Vale College, Tegan went on to study economics at the University of Bristol and now works as an analyst for Macquarie, a leading global financial services company in London. She is a fantastic example to our learners of how it's possible to balance and achieve excellence in both academic study and chosen sport. What a brilliant story, so inspirational. Please give a big round of applause to Tegan, our Alumni Award winner. Well done, Tegan. Our second award winner of the Alumni Award goes to Jack Boston. Okay, right then. While studying on what was then the foundation degree in music technology, Jack was working on his own productions, collaborating with other musicians and vocalists. Jack worked very hard to forge a career in recording and producing some of the best local bands to come out of Cardiff, having perfected his craft. How about this? Jack now works at the world-renowned Rockfield Studios in Monmouth. So if you go through your record libraries at home, I still call them records, or vinyl, or cassettes, or CDs, or downloads, you will see the Queen. I think I'm right in saying the Queen recorded Bohemian Rhapsody in Rockfield. Is that right? Yeah? And Oasis recorded What's the Story, Morning Glory? When I think Liam hit Noel with a cricket bat in the garden. Yeah. Still got the cricket bat? Yeah, there you go. There's a bit of music knowledge for you, ladies and gentlemen. And I think Iggy also recorded an album there as well. I mean, just incredible, incredible. So, Jack also works as the main recording engineer with a host of famous names. It is a truly remarkable story. He's a great example of creating a successful career out of your passion. We're very proud of you, Jack. Many congratulations. Fantastic. Jack Boston, ladies and gentlemen. Amazing, fantastic, and so lovely to see you, Tegan and Jack, and thank you very much indeed for coming this evening. The final award of the evening then, Overall Learner of the Year Award. This is top secret. Only a small number of people know who the winner of this award is. I'm one of them. The award celebrates the students who's gone above and beyond during their time at the college, quite simply, and had a positive impact on staff and learners across the college. The winner is a student who has really gone that extra mile to contribute to college life and also made a real difference to life here and is chosen from one of the category winners already announced tonight. So, to present this award, please welcome to the stage Group Principal Kay Martin and Chair of Corporation for his 7th award, Geraint Evans.
Good evening. Going through all these fantastic learners, as Jason has said, it's been really tough this year to choose some winners from the people already announced. So it's been a really tough journey, and any of you winners here tonight could be getting these awards, but somebody's got to win. Okay, so we've picked 2 overall winners because it was so tough we couldn't choose one. One has demonstrated academic excellence that has taken them on to Oxbridge Higher Education, bit of a clue. And one has represented the college and themselves brilliantly at competitions at both regional and national levels and is a shining example of what vocational learning and apprenticeships can achieve. Both can be very proud of their fantastic achievement. The winners of the Overall Learner of the Year Award are Anis Wiltshire and Omar Wahid.
Congratulations to Anis and Omar. Llongwrachademawr, Ardderchog, Bendigedig. Absolutely thrilled to announce those winners this evening. All of you tonight, the 2 very special winners. And don't forget, Omar, don't forget your social media picture as well. Many congratulations. I mean, what incredible stories we have heard this evening. And just before I invite Kay back onto the stage to say a few closing remarks, I just want to say one thing as well, that we've heard about hard work, dedication, resilience. For those of you who don't know my background, I was a student here at this college. Not here, because this is a new building and I'm very old. It was at the old Trowbridge site, College Llanhafren. And I just want to say this, and this is no messing around, because those of you who listen to my radio show know I don't mess around, that it was at College Llanhafren back in 1992 that fueled my desire to work in the media. And studying my media studies A-levels at College Llanhafren then, I was chosen to make a film in St Paul de Leon about the twinning towns between Penarth and St Paul de Leon. So those opportunities that have now come my way in my broadcasting career wouldn't have happened, and I mean this, wouldn't have happened had it not been for the opportunity I had during my A-levels at College Llanhafren now Cardiff and Vale College. And that is why tonight is so important, to hear those remarkable stories of people who, A, may have turned their lives around, B, thrown absolutely everything at their education, and C, who just grafted at getting where they are today. And I want to say this, genuinely, hand on heart, that if it wasn't for my time doing my A-levels at Coleg Llanhafran, I wouldn't be standing here tonight in front of you, having just come back from the World Cup, covering the World Cup for S4C. I wouldn't be sitting in a radio studio tomorrow morning talking about some of the biggest stories in our country. I wouldn't be there on a Saturday afternoon presenting the football, because it was at college that I got the drive, determination, and worked with incredible teachers who inspired me and made me understand and gave me the confidence to be able to succeed in this business. So I want to take this opportunity to thank this college for fueling my creativity and imagination way back when. And it gives me such great pleasure to see so many learners doing the very same thing many, many years on. So congratulations, keep at it. And I'll just end with a quote that I used here in this very same building back in May when we had a little graduation ceremony for the academy. Muhammad Ali, the great sportsman, the great boxer, once said, "Champions aren't made in gyms. Champions are made from something they have deep inside them. They have to have the skill and the will, but the will must be stronger than the skill." Thank you very much indeed for listening. And please give, once again, a very warm welcome to Kay Martin, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, Jason. Not much has changed, really, but we got fireworks now and everything. we couldn't afford fireworks in those days. Okay. Well, good evening, everybody. We're nearly there, and I know I'm the only thing between you and your transport home, so I'll be brief. The achievements tonight have been absolutely amazing, and as Sharon said at the beginning, this is the first time since 2019 that we've been together to celebrate these events. And it's especially pertinent for us because there were some people here in 2019 who are not here with us now. And, you know, particularly Bart Haynes, our Vice Chair of Governors, amongst other members of staff and family members too. So if we can, you know, just take a time tonight when we think of all the achievements of the learners, think of those staff members and those governors who inspired those learners to achieve what they have achieved. So I'd like to give my congratulations to all of you, but also to your family members and parents, children, you know, boyfriends, girlfriends, everybody who supported you on your journey. I'd like to, because without your family supporting you, it's really difficult to achieve qualifications and move on. I'd like to thank the staff as well, who supported you through your learning journey and helped you enjoy your time at college, and sometimes rang your parents or your children up if you didn't attend college. I'd like to thank as well our marketing and events team for doing a terrific job this evening in organising this and making sure we were here. Thank you as well to the students and staff who prepared some of the food and the drinks for you earlier. I hope you enjoyed all that. My particular favourite was the fish and chips. So I hope you all managed to get some of that, because I think I had three portions. Okay. It is, however, you know, it's a real privilege to, you know, we often talk here, the staff and the senior managers, we often talk what a privilege it is to be here in a college like this, transforming the lives of learners. But when we were in lockdown, it was really difficult when we were doing all these awards, talking to a blank screen. It's so much more lovely to see all you glamorous people out there, you know, looking all happy and, you know, lovely. And, you know, it's really nice to be back in person. But it is really a privilege to be here. And it's events like this that give our staff the will to go on. And, you know, because sometimes it's hard getting those students to do the work. Some of the people winning awards today, you know, they weren't always like that. We had to push them along sometimes. And, you know, the staff make it happen. And I know a lot of you write letters to those members of staff. And I'd just like to formally thank the staff as well. But it's a really privilege to work here. Changing lives is really, really easy for us, we think. Learning is what changes lives. Sometimes this is subtle, sometimes it is huge and life-changing. All of you here tonight can use your learning to go on and make a difference in everything you do. All the award winners are the pinnacle of our students, and you are the ones that we expect to go on and do great things in the world. So once again, a huge congratulations to you all. Enjoy the rest of the evening. You've deserved it. And I'll hand back to Jason.
Thank you, Kate. Thank you, Kate. For those of you who've been to the ceremony before, as Kate says, back in 2019, we have a tradition where we pose for a group selfie. It's our moment where we all become a little bit Hollywood, like they did at the Oscars a few years back. And I'm going to take a picture with Sarah's phone because I've forgotten my phone, which is now in my coat pocket, which is by the technical team. So Sarah's going to very kindly pass me her phone. And we're going to do a little selfie, okay? Well, it's quite a big selfie, actually. So I'm going to ask you all to stand up, if I can. Are we using this camera or that camera? Okay, we're going to get a selfie of the selfie, okay? And you're going to give a big cheer and a big wave, and I'm going to try and keep my head out of it as much as possible and get all you lovely, glamorous people in. So do your ties up, do your top buttons up, sort those jackets out, whatever you need to do, because this is going to go on social media and it's our annual photo. Okay, are we all ready? You're looking gorgeous, can I say. You're looking marvellous. So big smiles at the back there from Ali. Hello, Ali, I can see you. Big smile from Ali at the back. Are you all ready? Yeah? Come on, you got to give. Come on. Are you ready?
Yes!
It's like banto.
Okay, here we go then. Right, here we go then. Turn around, selfie time. Big cheer, 3, 2, 1. Yay!
There you go. There we go. And we've got a selfie of the selfie. There you go. Give yourselves a big round of applause. Thank you. Right. If I can ask you all to take your seats very, very quickly, and we'll just do a couple of thank yous, and then we shall bid you farewell, good night, and Merry Christmas. So before we conclude this evening's event, please, would you put your hands together? A very, very big appreciation, please, to say a huge thank you to this evening's event sponsor, University of South Wales. Give them a warm, warm round of applause. Prifysgol De Cymru. Thank you so much, Diolch o Galon, for helping us to celebrate our learners' achievements. Thank you to all of you in the audience as well, both here and online, for joining us this evening to celebrate this wonderful college and wonderful achievements, and also our business partners as well. Please can I ask all of our winners as well from the evening to stand up where you are. So each and every one of you stood up, whether you're business, whether you're here on academic achievements, and we're going to give you one big massive cheer, like we're at a big football ground or rugby stadium, and a big cheer and a big round of applause for our learners and our team. Should all be very, very proud of yourself. Once again, I know Kay has done it. Thank you to Sarah and Daniel and the team as well for putting on tonight's event, and our technical team as well. It's something I tell the students here when I'm working with them as well, always thank your technical team, because without them, number one, they can make you look really daft by taking your mic down at the wrong time. There you go. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I told you it was panto season. Never miss an opportunity. Thank you very much. Let's put our hands together for our brilliant technical team, ladies and gentlemen. Woo! And the man who took my fader down won't be here next year. He's just lost the gig.
But that's okay.
And he won't be here in 2024 either. It's that time then tonight for me to say congratulations to everyone here this evening. Staff, learners, whatever your involvement in the college, congratulations to you all. Llong gyfarched y mawr. I'll bid you farewell. Good night. Thank you very much indeed for coming. And Merry Christmas. Nadolig llawn. Diolch yn fawr iawn.